We all have an inflammatory reaction when we injure ourselves, as do birds, as do mammals, as do reptiles. We've managed to survive somehow with the exact right amount of physiology response to injuries. We've been injured since the beginning of time. So what the body does when it gets injured, it has an inflammatory response in order to start the healing process, whether you sprain an ankle, twist the wrist, or whatever. To me, trying to get rid of inflammation after an acute soft tissue injury is like trying to get rid of coagulation and taking anticoagulant pills after you cut yourself, thinking that coagulation is a pathological thing. Are you kidding me? Coagulation is the most wonderful thing the body does. Oh, but the body coagulates incorrectly. Are you kidding me? Unless you're hemophiliac or something. Clotting is the fundamental physiological response the body has when it's been injured to stop its bleeding, and it happens the right amount in healthy individuals. And inflammation is a fundamental response to tissue damage. Why are we trying to reduce it or stop it? To me, it's insanity. People ask me, how long should I protect my ankle for? How long should I limp for? And I ask them this question. When a dog hurts its foot, how long should a dog limp for? How long does the doctor, vet, or tell the dog, you should limp for 4 weeks or 3 days? Or how long do this research studies inform the dog that it should limp for? The answer is, the dog limps for as long as it needs to. That's how we've evolved. Listen to your body is the best answer. We still don't have one shred of evidence to support that icing is effective, believe it or not. You know, we always talk about this conflicting research. You know, one research says one thing, the other research study says other thing. But in the case of ice and acute soft tissue injury, there is no conflict. There's yet to be a study that showed ice was effective. So every study shows it's ineffective. It doesn't make a difference. Compression does help, elevation does help, but the actual icing, there is no conflict. We've been brainwashed so much in the last number of decades that you must ice. And if you ask people, well, where's the evidence for that, that ice reduces inflammation or speeds up healing? They say, oh, it must be there. I suggest you look up the systematic reviews, which all overwhelmingly conclude after 35 studies, 22 clinical trials, not one of them supports the use of ice. Ice does have a numbing effect on the skin. That's it. It numbs the pain. Post-surgery, post-ACL repair, knee replacement, ice does have an effect on numbing the skin. And some studies show, even those conflicting, that it reduces the need for medication. So if you use cryotherapy after surgery for pain, I'm okay with it. But don't say it reduces inflammation, because it doesn't. If they really like heat, put the heat on. If they like jacuzzis and hot shower, go for the hot shower and jacuzzi. Basically, the rule is, ask them, what do you prefer? So that's my answer. What do you prefer to put on?